We are off to a house which I think is really quite special. We're going to meet a guy called James Shuckburgh, and he is the owner of Shuckburgh Hall. And the family have been there for 1,000 years.
Really?
They've never, never had an antique dealer in the house to buy things.
Quite wise too.
Shuckburgh Hall lies within 3,500 acres of countryside that's home to an array of wild animals, including a herd of deer. Sitting on the borders of Warwickshire and Northamptonshire, the estate has been the seat of the Shuckburgh family since the 11th century, and the current custodian is Sir James Shuckburgh.
Family's been here for 1,000 years. It's one of the oldest families to be still living on the same spot in the whole of the country. We've got records going back towards 1200 in the Doomsday Book. For the future, I would like to see this house work for itself. It needs redecorating, rewiring, which isn't cheap in this day and age. So every single penny we can get will go towards the estate and towards the house itself. It's a Grade 2-star property. I'd like to hopefully sell some things, or maybe a lot of things.
Oh, yes.
When are we moving in?
We'll take it. If you could have this house for nothing, but you had to live in it with me, would you?
Don't know. Who would kill who first? That'd be the question, wouldn't it?
James, how you doing?
Well, well.
Nice to meet you. Drew?
Come in, please.
Hi, MP. How you doing? You all right?
Well, yep.
Thanks for having us. Marvellous. Oh, my. Wow. James, amazing.
Thank you very much.
Amazing. So tell me about the place, then.
We've been here for roughly 1,000 years. still on the same spot.
So you farm here, then, still?
It is a farming estate. There are 19 tenant farmers and 25 cottages which we let out.
I'm hoping for some really good finds, because will I ever get the opportunity to go through a house like this again in this condition? I don't think so. I'm sort of a bit gobsmacked, really.
I'm so trying to work out where you're going to start.
I don't know where to start.
There's so many places.
I don't know where to start. There's so much in here. I mean, it's just mind-blowing. Look at that. Wow. It's like a time capsule.
Nothing's really been altered at all.
But nothing in the main body of the buildings for sale? These
no.
are all. That's all
no.
out of the way?
Out
okay.
of the way.
I'm a bit gobsmacked. Can we have a look around?
Yes.
Do you mind?
Welcome. No.
Which way first?
Shall we go
show
you through to the saloon?
This is the most quintessentially English country house interior I have ever seen, bar none. Everything about it is just screaming total authenticity. Age, patina, colour, it just goes on and on and on. If you've got millions and millions of pounds and you employ the best interior designers in the world, they can just about get close to this, but never as authentic as this.
The pieces in this part of the house might not be for sale, but even the chance to appreciate them is a rare treat for Drew.
Oh, my God, look at this. Oh, look at that table. You've got that ensuite as well, the console ensuite. Is there another one of those?
There's another one up.
You've got two of those.
Stair, two of those.
About right.
Yeah.
Look at that. Oh, my life. This is quite staggering for me. Because these would have been known makers that they'd have used for the house. They'd have been people of standing, particularly for that one. But these feel like these have been made for here.
Yeah, you've got the family crest as well.
Yeah. It doesn't get better, it just continues. Look at the tapestries on the wall. Look at the ceiling. I mean, really, look at the ceiling. It's quite incredible. Fabulous pieces of furniture. It just goes on and on. I can't tell you how much I love this place when James goes on holiday and changes the locks. It's it's pretty fantastic.
Having had a tour of the rooms that are being kept as they are, from here on in, anything Drew likes the look of could be for sale.
Oh, my word. This place just gets better, doesn't it?
Yep.
And you just grew up here?
Grew up here. It's a room which I'd like to try and get done up as a bit of a boys' toy room.
I would leave it exactly as it is. Look at that. That red?
Yep.
Just perfect.
Probably paint it again red.
No!
No?
No. No. This is me being selfish. For me, I would clean up some of it, but I'd leave the red. I wouldn't touch it. That's only ever going to be like that once. And I wouldn't touch it ever. But the red is just magnificent. I'm just falling in love with this house more and more. I bang on about the country house aesthetic all the time and about proportion and wear and patina and fading. And this is just everywhere. Every inch of it is covered in that.
Coming to the girls' playroom.
Oh, my word. James, thank you very much. It's a belter. You've probably got another one to match somewhere.
We have, but it's a lot bigger.
OK, it's a hay rake table. When I came here today, I had pretty high expectations. Walk into this very unassuming little child's game room for his daughters. Bam. Can't believe my eyes. There's an oak hay rake table, early 20th century, in the English arts and crafts manor. What a wonderful thing.
Hay rake tables were first designed by Ernest Gimson, who was a well-respected figure in arts and crafts furniture during the early 20th century. They're recognisable by the distinctive double-ended Y shape at the base, and once restored, this one could be worth around £4,000.
Not going to mess about, I'll give you £2,000 for it.
Fair enough.
Yeah?
Yep, thank you.
Marvellous.
I'll give you another tenner if you get it out the door.
No chance.
Didn't mess about, there's no point in trying to pull the wool over James' eyes. Give you £2,000 for it. That's a very fair bid for it in the condition it's in. I want to own it, and I want James to call me the next time he's selling stuff, so I don't want to mess around. Also, I've got my hand on this chair, and this is a particularly good chair underneath all this as well, which is fairly obvious. It's obvious for me because I recognised it as soon as I walked through the door with that square top across there. It's a Howard & Sons easy armchair. So we need to just pull this about and have a quick look. Is this something you want to get rid of?
Yep.
It's not in great nick, but that's why it's in the child's gaming room here. But I recognise it. It isn't stamped on the rear leg, hasn't got the original ticking on it, but I definitely recognise the style, the quality, and then also the casters are all stamped up correctly.
Widely regarded as one of the best chair makers of the Victorian era, Howard & Sons are renowned for their craftsmanship and the use of the finest materials. This armchair will need to be completely reupholstered, but once done, it could be worth around £1,500.
This isn't a very saleable model, but it is the quality is fantastic. And if you've got one, you've probably got a few more. Because of the model, I'm going to give you £450 for it as it is.
Okay.
Is that acceptable?
Yep. Thank you very much.
Marvellous, thank you. You know, I'm sort of holding out all day, waiting for something really special to pop up, and those two things right there, just in... right next to each other.